more common problems that you might run into with these 75 to 95 Mercedes has to do with the speedometer, particularly the odometer. It seems like many times after, you know, 180, 200,000 miles, the odometer will stop working, and when it does, you don't know how much mileage between oil changes. You may have a problem with, you know, knowing when to fuel up and so on. So there's a lot of information floating around about how to fix these. It is something that people have been able to do. You know, you got to take everything apart, and you could have problems with the needle jumping. There's other things that could be going on with the speedometer itself, but generally, most of these are the same all the way. Now, granted, when we get up into the middle 80s, they became electronically controlled rather than just by using a cable like you see on this 1979 Mercedes here. But we found over the years, it's just better to send these out to a professional for repair, because when they come back, everything's going to be set, everything's going to be correct, and it's even going to be calibrated for the right speed. So I do not recommend this as a DIY job, particularly for the cost of having a professional do that. And as we go on into this video, I'll tell you who I recommend that you would send your speedometer out if you're having problems with it. But I'm sitting in this 79-300SD. The odometer has not been working now for about 3 months. So we're going to pull it out. We're going to pull the speedometer out and send it off. Now, one of the things that's kind of cool about these older Mercedes in this era is that the instrument cluster, we call this whole section here, is only pressed in, and it can be pulled out. We've got on my website, I've got a couple of tools that you can get in here to help you pull these out, because they really get in there tight. But once it's out like this, once you get the cluster out, you've got to reach in behind, you've got to disconnect the speedometer cable, disconnect the oil pressure line if it's a mechanical, disconnect the wiring plug, the lights and so on. I'm not going to go over that in this video. That's not the purpose of this video. We're just going to talk more specifically about speedometer repair. But if you don't know how to get in to your cluster, get it out safely, I do have a manual on my website which will walk you through that process. So I'm going to go ahead now. I'm going to get a good light. I'm going to get some tools. I'm going to get this oil pressure line off. I'm going to get the plug out. And in the center here, I've got to get in there and get that speedometer cable housing loose. That's a kind of a nut that's sometimes really hard to get to. If you can't get to that with your hand, it won't turn. Sometimes you can get a channel lock, a small channel lock plier back in here and get that loose. So we'll get this out, and then I can show you how we're going to remove the speedometer from the cluster. Okay, here's the cluster upside down on the bench. I recommend you pat it, because you can scratch the housing. Be real careful. The face is easy to scratch as well. Most of these clusters, they contain three instruments. You know, you have the engine control instruments here, which include the oil pressure, you know, the engine temperature, and the fuel tank level. And then the speedometer is always in the middle, okay? And then over here, you have the clock, or the combination clock and tachometer. The procedure for removing the speedometer is different on the different chassis. In the 116, it's pretty straightforward. Sometimes you have to take off one or two of the other instruments to get the speedometer off, but in this case, the speedometer can come off with leaving these other two instrument groups in place. I've pulled the long bolt out and removed the dash light potentiometer, or the dimmer switch. And then you've only got three screws to remove here on this speedometer housing. You want to be a little careful when you pull it out of there. A lot of them you need to kind of, you know, tip or tilt a little bit as you lift it up and out. Now let's see how this one comes out. Now I'm going to lift it in the back, and then I can pull it out. And there you see it, you know, 209,000 miles. Obviously, if you look in here, you can see the gearing that drives the odometer. The odometer is stuck at 27.5 miles, and there it has been for the last few months. Now, we're going to send this out to Rick at Overseas Speedometer. We've been using Rick for close to 15 years, and some of you think I'm trying to advertise, you know, another company, but really, I have no reservations at giving a shout out to someone who is doing a really good job, particularly a really good job with passion. And Rick's that way. He loves what he does. You know, so, but there are a couple things, and we see this too. Rick sees it. He mentioned, be sure and tell people how to pack these. You cannot just take this instrument and throw it in a box. And you don't want to throw it in a box with a bunch of peanuts. You're going to have peanuts stuck everywhere in this thing. So let me show you how we prep it for packing, because if you're going to send yours out as well, you should do this to protect this instrument. The most important thing is to protect the face of the instrument, and particularly the needle. This is very fragile, and you can't believe what these shipping companies do to these packages. So you can get this can become dented, or this can be all bent out of shape. And so just take a little extra care. Look what I've done here. I've taken a piece of cardboard and I've cut it so it's, of course, wider than the depth of the speedometer. I've wrapped it around. I've punched a couple holes here and here so the speedometer can't move in and out. And then I've taped this tight. So what I've done is I've provided at least an inch barrier here above the face of the needle so nothing can come and, you know, hit this. Now, once this is done, I can pack this. You can either double box it, or what I do is I put a plastic bag over this, put this in a plastic bag, and then set it in a box and pack it with peanuts or pack it with packing paper. Once again, put a plastic bag around this so when Rick gets this, it's not full of junk from your packing material. So we're going to get this shipped off. You know, it'll be a couple weeks when we get it back here. I'll just run over quickly some of the highlights of getting this back in the car, and then I want to talk a little bit more about overseas speedometer. The speedometer's back from repair and it looks great. It just cosmetically looks superb. And by the way, if you have an older Mercedes speedometer where there's some cosmetic problems, in other words, fading of the numbers or fading of the paint on the needle, Rick can do that type of restoration as well. So be sure and ask him about that if you want a pristine, like, old speedometer. Now, this looks great. You know, the original mileage is set. It's perfectly lined up. The odometer is set at 000, and it is also all those numbers are perfectly lined up, shows that it's been done properly. Now, to put this back in, you know, it's going to vary between the different models, but it's not difficult. Just take your time and be a little careful. You don't want to bend anything. But one thing I forgot to mention in the last scene is when you put this away while you're waiting for this to return, I would recommend you cover this over with some plastic or saran wrap or something. You don't want a lot of junk and dust getting down inside here. It's kind of hard to clean the back side of that plastic face. So I've double checked. There's no dust and dirt in there. We're going to set this speedometer in place. Kind of work it under the wire, tip it over here so this corner clears, and then set it right down in place. It should sit flush in there. Don't force it. If you're trying to force it, something's not right. Either the odometer, reset lever's not lined up properly. Now it's just a matter of, you know, I've got the potentiometer reinstall along with the long bolt and then those three short bolts, and we're ready to put this back in the car. And it's going to be great to have an odometer that works again. Now, I asked Rick to share a little bit about his company and also about some of the other problems you could run into with a speedometer. I'll let him share that with you in the next segment of this video.
Ken asked me to mention some items that go wrong with these speedometers. One thing I'd like to make clear is the trip meter works off of the movement of the odometer. They're interconnected by a small little gear, so that will put your mind at ease. So the main odometer stops and the trip stops with it. Here's some problems with the odometer. It won't move, it turns too fast, or it's intermittent. That pretty much stands the same for mechanical and electronic speedometers. The trip meter sometimes will not reset to zero. Sometimes the numbers won't line up straight. As far as the calibration, sometimes it's too small, too fast, or too slow. Sometimes the needle moves rapidly back and forth or bounces. Sometimes it won't advance off zero. Sometimes it pegs out. Sometimes the unit squeals, particularly in older mechanical speedometers. Sometimes there's no speedo or no odo. Before you jump to conclusions, if there's no speedo or no odo, check your cable. That could be broken or crimped or a gear bad in the transmission. Hope that helps you realize that there's more to it than fixing a slipping gear.
So you might be thinking, well, what makes overseas speedometer particularly qualified to work on these instruments? Well, Rick started this business way back in the late 80s when he was frustrated he couldn't find anybody to fix his wife's Volvo broken odometer. And so he started messing around with these himself, and then he started working out of his garage, helping other people with their speedometer problems. You know, this is classic. I mean, this is kind of how my business started. And then eventually, you know, you get a warehouse and you have to get employees. By the mid-1990s, the business became full-time for Rick, and he over the last 20 years, he's probably repaired 25,000 to 30,000 speedometers. And it's not just speedometers what he does. They do clocks, they do tacks, they do cosmetic types of repair, and they don't only just work on Mercedes-Benz. You'll need to contact him. I'll put the links, of course, in the description of this video. But, you know, I've got my 300 SD done now. I was so impressed with the work. I've got the instruments out of one of my really old Mercedes 111 coupes. I'm going to send those out. Now, they're working, but hey, if Rick can do this for me and cosmetically get them really looking nice, I would rather have those instruments in my old Benz fixed, knowing they're going to be working for a long time to come, not just some day down the road. And that's usually what happens. The odometers will go out just like that on these. There's no prediction. And the same with clocks. You might have an old clock that's kind of working, but I've got one of my old Ponton clocks here that I'm going to be sending out. It's got a little bit of discoloration in one of the needles here. So I'll have them go through the clock, cosmetically restore it, and send those back as well. So, you know, it's kind of interesting how he works. He sets the work schedule up in his shop, and there's times they'll do like BMW motorcycle instruments, and they'll work on specialty clocks. Here he talks about working one of the problems he had working on a clock for a Mercedes 190.
Manuela is working on a clock project for a restoration shop. There are three 190 Mercedes clocks, 1961. We're supposed to pick the best one and try to get it going with parts from the other one. We have an issue of discoloration of the lens, quality of the face, bezel quality, and then we have one here that is a little bit funkier on the outside, but it's running. So we're going to pursue with the running clock and try to get the cosmetics straightened out after we get the clock proven up.
So if you find yourself in need of some speedometer or instrument repair or restoration, I highly recommend that you contact Rick Borth at Overseas Speedometer. Once again, I'll put the links. You've got to click on the show more. And remember, in YouTube, you won't see all the description below. You have to click show more, and it'll take you to some all the links that I can come up with to help you in relationship to these type of problems. I'll put a link there to the manual that I have on how to get the clusters and the instruments out of your dash if that's something you'd like information on as well. So, you know, I've rolled the 300 SD outside. Okay, it's outside, it's kind of raining. In closing, I should mention, you know, I'm doing a lot of videos on these 1975 to 1995 Mercedes-Benz, and if you want to follow along on this series or any of my other series, I have a series for the newer Benzes, and I have the older, more classic Mercedes that I'm working on now. I'll be doing a special feature on the W113 chassis, and I've got a 6.3 that I'll be restoring over the next year or so. So we'll be shooting a lot of videos. I'm talking about a lot of videos. If you want to be able to follow along on those. I highly recommend that you subscribe to my channel so you'll get notification when all these videos come out. And don't be afraid to look through the playlist. I have over 600 videos, so it's really hard to find some of these, but I've tried to organize them by the playlist on the left side of the YouTube page. So be sure and check out my playlist as well. Now, let's follow along. I'm going to take you on a little ride here. Let's go outside and hop in that 300SD and let's find out if that odometer really works. The speedometer is reinstalled in the 300SD. Now it's time to take this baby out on a test ride. And let's see, you can see it's nicely installed and we're ready to fire this baby up, get in here and get out on the road and see if that odometer works now. Okay, we're cruising down the road now and I'm looking down at the odometer and look at that. Isn't that great? Finally, we have an odometer telling us how many miles we've driven between oil changes. This is another speedometer successfully repaired by Overseas, and thank you, Rick.